Hello friends, welcome to this YouTube lecture where I am going to guide you as how you could pass the AWS Certified Solutions Architect Associate exam. Particularly this is not just to pass the Certified Solutions Architect Associate exam. By using this approach you could prepare for any of the AWS certification exam. I gave this exam very recently, that is on 13 August 2018. So let me first show you the my exam certificate and then we will discuss briefly about two steps upon how we can prepare for this examination. So let's go to AWS certification. AWS certification page. My certification account. So I am already logged into my account, and over here in the achieved certification you could see the certification. So this is the certification, AWS Certified Solutions Architect Associate exam. I gave this exam on 13 August 2018, and from here we can just download the PDF certificate. So this is the certificate. So this is just to give you an idea as how this certificate looks, and when you will give this exam, this is how you will get this certificate. So let's talk about the approach and how, what are the best practices we could follow to clear this examination. So prerequisites. So actually don't worry, there are no particular prerequisites that you have to follow to give this examination. If you don't know anything already about AWS, it's just that you have to practice all the required topics. So here is the link, which is an important link for particularly this associate exam, and there are links to there are such type of details associated with every kind of certification exam, where you could download the exam guide, where you could download the sample questions, and there are some other important information like about the exam, like multiple choice questions will be there, exam duration, practice exam registration fees, exam registration fees that is $150 as of today, and then you can go and schedule your exam. So let's move back. Now what is the most important thing? The most important thing is get your hands dirty. The thing is that you have to go to AWS website and create your free tier account. You must play with AWS services like IAM, S3, EC2, VPC, DynamoDB, RDS, etc. And all of these services alone contributes to about 75% of the exam questions. So it is 100% mandatory that you create your own account and play with it if you want to learn deeply in and out all of these services. The second important thing is frequently asked questions. For every service there is an associated list of frequently asked questions, like for S3, SQS, DynamoDB, ECT, etc. Make sure you read all of the frequently asked questions associated with these services, and you can find all of these questions on the AWS website. Second is that you try to find some of the sample questions online and try to solve these questions, or give the practice AWS exam first before appearing into the actual exam, so that at least you know the level of your preparation, and then only you spend more on the actual exam. Go for the AWS training online or classroom. The thing is that there are types of AWS full-fledged courses on the particular certification that you want to give, that are online or and in the classroom also. So I would recommend that if you are very new to the AWS, you should go for the online or offline training. Online trainings are available on this link, where and they are given by offered by the AWS certified partners. And there are offline offline and online both are available on this link, and there are other online training courses that are available on Udemy and other such websites which are good, and you can take them just to practice for the exam. So what all I did to pass this exam? So these were some of the things that I recommended, and these are exactly now I'm going to tell you about what all I did step by step to clear this examination. I created a free tier account and did hands-on on services like IAM, S3, EC2, and I would wait that the weightage that I would give to this practice point is about 50%. I studied frequently asked questions for various services, and then I did 3-day classroom training which I would weigh around 30% of my exam preparation. So friends, this was all about the approach that I wanted to discuss with you so that you could prepare for your examination. And make sure that there is like no particular way or there is not any fixed approach, but using these or following these steps, you will definitely going to pass your AWS certification exam. Yeah, just one thing that I missed is that the amount of time to prepare may vary person to person depending upon his background in the IT sector or depending upon the amount of work he has done previously in the AWS. So it may vary. For me, as an IT professional, it took me approximately 1.5 months to prepare for to do all such things and prepare for the exam. So thank you for watching this YouTube video, and best of luck for your exam.